Hey everyone, in this video let's look at the Vivo V15 Pro's features or other hidden settings. So there are a lot of settings that Vivo V15 provides, and that's what I'll be covering. I've already made two of these videos. If you haven't watched that yet, make sure you watch that, hit that like button, share with your friends, and if you are new to my channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button. I've made a lot of variety contents on this channel, so make sure you do click on that subscribe button and watch my videos. So in today's video, I'll be sharing you more interesting settings, so make sure you watch full video. Alright, getting started with the video. First thing you have to do is to go to the settings here, and if you know the S capture, if you just tap on the S capture here, circle with a lot of options appear here, you can actually move it to wherever you want. The thing is here, you usually record the screen. So while you usually record the screen, the audio does not get recorded. So how to enable audio settings for this record screen? So that's again inside this settings. So what you have to do is go to the settings, and here there is S capture menu, just tap on that. So here what you have to do is scroll down, then you'll find record voice. This is where you enable for the screen recording. So while it is recording the screen, if you want your audio to be recorded as well, so make sure you enable this one. By default it will be disabled, so make sure you enable it in order to record your voice along with the screen as well. So if you didn't know about that setting, now you know. So don't forget to hit that like button, guys. So the next setting we'll be looking is how to take screenshot quickly. A lot of people find it difficult to take the screenshot inside Vivo phone. It's very easy actually. You have to take three fingers and swipe it upward just like this. So if you just swipe it like that, you'll have this one. And if you just tap on the long screenshot, you can continuously take screenshot in one image. Let's say you're browsing the news, or if you're having more than one pages, what you can do is use the long screenshot. Just keep on scrolling, and how much ever you want, you can actually scroll that much. As you can see here, just keep on scrolling and then tap on save. So basically a full screenshot will be saved in one image. So that's again a very nice feature. Again, if you are finding this three swipe to be very complicated, instead what you can do is to just hold the power button and volume down button, power and volume down button, in order to take the screenshot. Boom, there you go. Again, you have this screenshot here. So that's a little trick that you can use to instantly save your screenshot. So the next feature is again here, app clone. As you can see, there is an app clone feature. You can always do this on the home screen as well. If you just tap and hold the particular icon of the app, you can enable it by tapping on the plus mark. Otherwise, there is always here, if you just enable app clone, again it's cloning app. So there will be two WhatsApp you can use, or rather two Facebook. So again, it's a very handy feature which is located in the settings, app clone. So the next feature is again inside the settings. Here you'll find the security and privacy. So inside security and privacy, what you can do is to enable the file safe box. So here's the file safe box. You can enable it from here. Otherwise, what you can do is you can just move to the file manager here on the home screen, or rather from the home screen. Again, here you will find the file safe. You can always enable it from here. Now there are several password options for file safe. What it basically does is it creates a separate safe box for you. If you have any private documents, private pictures, private videos, everything can be stored in private. Only you will be able to access with using any of these password options that you have set already. So let's say I set the pattern one. So I'll create a simple pattern for the demonstration. You have to do it twice, of course. And once you have done that, you have to answer the security questions. So I'll just tap the simple ones. You can do as per your need. So once I done that, just tap on done and save, finish. So your file safe is ready now. So whatever you want, you can move your information into this file safe box. So it's basically a treasury box that's hidden inside your phone. Only you'll be able to access it. As you can see, choose files. If I just choose any of the pictures, let's say if I choose this one, and then let's tap on move in. Now that thing is moved to the file safe. You won't find this one in the gallery. So this is a very handy feature, and it's a protection feature. So if you have a lot of stuff that you don't want to share it with everyone, you can always keep those things in the file safe. It's located inside the file manager, or rather you can enable or go to that setting in from security and privacy. So settings, here's the security and privacy. Just tap on it and here you'll find the file safe box. Moving on, the next one is again inside the security and feature. What you can do is to block unwanted calls. That's again here, block unwanted. So from here, as you can see, you can block the blacklisted numbers, you can block harassing calls. All this can be done from the other setting that I showed in another video, but still there is again inside this one as well. So blocked call log. So if there are any calls from the blocked numbers, it will be shown over there. So all this can be done here. It all depends on your convenience. So you can enable it or disable it. So guys, after all these settings, there is very nice and very interesting feature what we have been seeing on the Samsung's phones, on the higher end phones. There is always on display on the Vivo V15 Pro. If you didn't know about that, now you know. I'll show you how to enable it. So just go to the settings, and here you have to go to the lock screen, home screen and wallpaper. Here what you have to do is turn on the always on display. Just tap on this, and here's where you have to enable it. Now if you didn't know about this really nice feature, hit that like button. Now you know it. What it basically does is, if I just lock the mobile, so if I'm just on the lock screen, or rather if I lock the mobile, here's the always on display. So you'll be shown notifications if you missed any calls, or if there are any messages that you didn't check. You can always use this always on display, meaning that even if you didn't unlock your device, this will be always on. So you can always use the time, you can always see the date, so which day it is, and also your battery percentage every time. So that's the always on feature, very nice feature. We usually have it on the Samsung phones, but now Vivo V15 Pro has provided you that as well. So you can change the clock type styles. So by default it is set to that. You can always keep these kind of variety of contents here. As you can see, there are a lot of things that you can do. You can customize the clocks, and depending on your taste, there are colors as well, as you can see. So just say apply, and lock screen display is enabled. There was again a very nice thing here, as you can see the side display. Let's say you are keeping your mobile phone on table a lot, and this one will be really handy. So you can set it this way as well. There is location setting here in order to keep for temperature. So it all depends on your preference. Again, there is this setting. If you didn't know about this, now you know. Enable this feature. I always use it, always on display, very handy feature. There is notification which you can enable, phone messages and for WhatsApp notifications. You change the timing here as well, start and end. Let's say you want to keep that always on display, morning to evening, you can again set the time. You can schedule that, or rather schedule that. So this is the always on display feature on the Vivo V15 Pro. So guys, these were the settings in this video. Let's end this video to this much. I'll be covering more settings, or rather more tips and tricks about the Vivo V15 Pro in another videos. And make sure you watch the first and second video that I have already made. So don't forget to hit that like button, share with your friends, and click on that subscribe button. See you all in another one. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.